Hello, everyone. Have you ever wondered what it takes to build an automated messenger experience? Questions like how long will it take, or how do I get started? In this session today, we will cover what it takes to build an automated messenger experience by doing a technical deep dive. Hi, I'm Jayesh Jain. I'm a partner engineer on the messenger team, and my job is to work with partners, help them achieve their business goals by proving return on investment is higher on Messenger. So there are over 40 million active businesses on Messenger. I'm pretty sure you got asked by your management, how do I get a presence on Messenger? So that's the agenda of my talk today. We will start from how do you build a Facebook page and integrate, have basic communication with your users on Messenger. We will do a deep dive into building an automated experience on Messenger. And then we'll look into further, how do you build a fully integrated messenger experience with live agents so that when you need to transfer support to live agent, you can do that. Your business would already have a Facebook page. If not, the first step is to create a Facebook page. Once you have a Facebook page, you can enable messaging from the page settings, and boom, you're ready to communicate with your users over Messenger. But as your business grows and the volume of messages you receive increases, and a lot of messages are repeated, like around store hours or return policy, you want to automate those messages. Okay, so one slide too soon. All right, technical difficulties, all right. So you can respond to your users in real time if you are already ready, or you can, wait, I'm missing one more slide, sorry. All right, okay. So once you enable that, you go to your pages inbox. If a user types a message on Messenger, you will get it here. They can do it from their messaging app or from the Facebook page. You see it here, you respond to it manually, right? It's the same experience as you would do exchange messages with your friends. This can be real time. Basically, if you are available online and someone types a message, you respond to it. Or it can be asynchronous, where you can respond after a few hours. The messenger thread is persistent, so you always resume where you left off. The only thing is it's manual. So as your business grows, now you want to respond to it in an automated fashion. As you saw earlier in Asha's keynote, 20 billion messages are being sent between businesses and people. Let's take pause for a second. 20 billion messages are being exchanged with businesses and people every month. This is a huge opportunity. So if your business is not active on Messenger, I would highly recommend to get started and do this. And before we jump into automation, I'd like to start with this quote from W.L.W. Borowiecki. If you automate a process that has errors, all you've done is automate the generation of those errors. So with that, let's jump. So today, we'll go through building an automated experience on Messenger with basic send-receive capability, and then also add, how do you add a button, a quick reply, a carousel, all in 12 simple steps. Follow with me. The first step is to create a Facebook app. To create one, you navigate to developers.facebook.com. Under My Apps, click on Add a New App. Enter the name of the app and your contact email. That's it. Just two pieces of information, and you have your Facebook app. The app you just created can be used for a variety of purposes. To build an automated experience on Messenger, we would add Messenger as a product. So far what you've done is create a Facebook app. But to have this automation to receive messages and send a message, we need to create a webhook. You can use any programming language to build your webhook, which talks REST. You can host it anywhere, Amazon Web Services, Microsoft Azure, Heroku, or even your own data servers, right, in your data center. What we do is you need to create a verify token. It can be any random string that you want. You go to subscribe a paid subscription, you put your URL for your webhook, right? This is to connect your webhook to your app. Once we receive this, what we do is the messenger platform will send you a GET request. In the GET request, we'll send you the verify token that you entered and a challenge string. On your side, when you process the GET request, you would verify that the token is the same that you have incorporated here, respond back with status 200 OK, and the challenge string back. So once the messenger receives it, we do verification is complete, and now we have associated the app that you created with this webhook. Good so far? All right. Next, we have this webhook, but what kind of events would you like to process? So we subscribe those events. You go to page subscription fields. For the basic send and receive, you need messages. For doing pushbacks like a button or for your carousel, you need messaging pushbacks. So with this two, you should be able to do the 12 steps what I mentioned. Next, so what you've done is create a Facebook app, made your webhook, associated webhook to the app, and we added events when your webhook will be invoked. But now users are sending messages to your Facebook page. So you need to subscribe your page, your webhook to this page. The way you do it is you go into Messenger settings, you select the page from the dropdown which you want to subscribe, and now you can subscribe the webhook that you had to this page. So that when users send a message to your page, it will connect to your be sent to your webhook and you can respond to them. And you would say, why do I have this dropdown? Because a Facebook app can be connected to multiple Facebook pages. So you now associate which Facebook page do you want to connect it to. And to send a message to a user, you need to authenticate. So to get the way you do authentication is using page access tokens. So to generate your token, you again go to your developers.facebook.com, messenger settings, under webhooks. You go under page tokens. Again, you select the page that you want, and you generate this page access token. You see that the screen is, the access token is only half, but it's by design. It's not a bug. It's a feature. I didn't want to put that actual token here, so that's why I cut it off here. Oh, one note though, you don't want to use the token hard-coded in your code. The way I do it, I normally use it as an environment variable so that it's not lying around in your code and floating around. Now, whenever someone sends a message to your webhook to Messenger or through your Facebook page, you would receive in your webhook a message. What we do is the webhook, we also send what's the event type. So you can say it's an event type message or a postback. And let's say you got a message, you get three pieces of information. What's the page ID, what's the PSID, and what's the message? Now let's talk about this PSID. A PSID is nothing but a page scoped user ID. What we do is for every user that interacts with your Facebook page, we generate this unique PSID, which is unique for a user for a given page. So for the same user for a different page, it would be a different PSID. Now, let's say you got a message saying, are you open for business today? So you got your webhook request, you process that message, and of course you want to respond back, right? Saying, we are closed today because we are attending F8, right? So how do you do? To send a message, you need three things primarily. A, whom to send the message, what message to send, and your authentication credentials. And as simple as that, you see we create a request body. It's a response because you're responding to the user's question. You add the sender PSID, you add the message text, and you make one, you call this URL graph.facebook.com/me/messages. You put the access token, and as simple as that, it will now be sent to the user. The beauty of it, and this and all the next, is you're calling the same URL, the same endpoint messages for sending all the following requests as well. And I'll show you step by step. So as of now, with this so far, you can process incoming requests from the users, and now you can respond back with messages that you want. Now to add the other things that I was talking about, like buttons. Let's say you want to add this button on your page. And this button, when you click on it, it should take the user to your website. The way you do it, again, you're sending the same request, but instead of message of type text, you would now invoke a button of type template. You say what text you want, what type of button, it's a web URL, because it should take the user to your website, and the URL address, and a title. With this, as simple as that, you're still making the call to the same slash me slash messages, same endpoint, same the token, and with this, boom, you are able to put a button in your message automation experience. Another good thing, if you're not familiar, is quick replies. Quick replies lets user, instead of typing the whole email address or if you have long strings, they can just tap on a response. For example, if you want an email address, and it's a long email address, you can use this quick reply. It's not being sent to your automated experience yet until the user taps on it. And the user, if the user wants to change it, they can do that too. They can type any other email address as well. But it's just a way of easing. If it's the same email address, they can just tap on it and they'll send it over to you. The way to do that, again, very straightforward. Instead of saying a generic template now, you'll put type quick replies. You'll say content type. And you can have, the reason you say content type is user email. You can even have phone number quick replies. You can have your custom text with some image as a quick reply. Like for colors, you want red or green, you can do that as well. Same concept, same endpoint, slash me, slash messages. With this as a body, you have quick replies. Simple so far? All right. Now let's add something more fancier, if that's straightforward. You want to have a carousel of images. A carousel is nothing but you have various cards. User can swipe through, see multiple images. It also lets you prioritize. So if summer is coming, right? So you can have summer collection as the first image that you want, and then next spring, and then so on. You can order the images as you want in the carousel. The code, again, follows the same template. It's a template type of type generic. But now for carousel, what you do is you create an array of elements here. So you have elements, you see the square brackets. So the same code you add for a different card that you want. You can add a different title, different image URL. And this would be of type postback. So when the user clicks on it, on your webhook site code, you can see what's the postback, the payload string, and now you know user has typed on spring collection or the summer collection, and you can take appropriate actions as you want. Cool. So your automated experience, it can solve majority of use cases, but it doesn't solve everything. There are questions which cannot be answered in automated fashion. So what we support is ability for you to transfer control to a live agent when you need to, when the need arises, when you can't answer the question. And let's see the code for how do you do that. And once the user is done, the live agent is done, you can transfer control back to your automated experience and you can resume the thread. It's all happening in the same thread. So the way you do is you create a secondary app, which is for supporting live agent, right? And we have this endpoint called pass thread control. And with this API, you can take your user thread, pass it to the secondary app, which is supporting live agent. The question arises, how do you pass context to live agent? Because they should know what is the question. You don't want them asking the user again, what is the question? So what we do is we support this metadata field, and whatever the question was which the user asked, you pass in the metadata field when you pass the control to the live agent, and they will know what question it was and they can start responding. To recap, we saw right from a Facebook page, without building an automated experience, how you can have a manual way to interact with the users on Messenger. We went through building 12 easy steps to build an automated experience on Messenger. And then we also went through how do you build an automated experience which can respond to users automatically as well as transfer control to live agent when needed. So if you have any further questions, I'll be at the Messenger booth. Feel free to stop by. Me or one of my, someone from my team will be able to, will be more than happy to answer your questions or dig deeper. Enjoy the rest of your conference. Thank you.